Okay, welcome to Stanford University. It's a beautiful sunny day today. We're here with Jerry Fuller, the Fletcher Jones II Professor of Chemical Engineering, world-renowned scientist with rheology and interfacial rheology.
Well, first the name, Langmuir. Very important American scientist in the early 1900s. Worked for General Electric, and he used a trough that was actually invented by a German woman, but we refer to the trough with his name. And I drew this trough earlier. Simply, it's usually a Teflon vessel because you need to keep everything clean in surface science. It's easy to clean very robustly, Teflon. So, and then you spread on top of the water, for usually, this layer of insoluble surfactants. It could be a phospholipid or a fatty acid, cholesterol. This insoluble layer, this is a Langmuir film. And remember, we can control that film by reducing the area and simultaneously measuring the surface pressure. We can establish the thermodynamics of this Langmuir film. Now, Langmuir had working with him a woman, scientist, last name of Blodgett, and she had this interesting idea of taking a plate and bringing it through that interface containing the Langmuir film, and she noticed a very remarkable effect. So I'll draw this in an expanded form. Here's this plate going down through the Langmuir film, and what she noticed was that she was able to, in a very systematic way, deposit these films on the surface of that plate that's going through the interface. So this is called the Langmuir-Blodgett or LB film. Now, the companies such as Biolin, when they produce a Langmuir trough with a Langmuir-Blodgett attachment, what they do, which is very important, when you make this deposition down this way, you're removing material from this top Langmuir film. And so the surface pressure is diminishing. So what they do is they automatically compress the film during deposition to keep that surface pressure constant. So you have a lot of control over the nature of this film. Now here's the interesting thing about this process. When you raise the plate up, you again produce a deposition. So when this film comes up, you'll produce a bilayer. Then you can repeat the process, trilayer, and then a four layer or quadra film. So you get a lot of control over the deposition process with this Langmuir-Blodgett deposition technique.